Hi, everyone. I'm Bill Pito, and welcome to On the Fly. It's great to have you with us for a recap of all 11 of Saturday's games. First up, Matthews against McDavid. We continue with the M's as in marquee matchup. 17 previous meetings, Matthews 12 goals and 6 assists. McDavid 8 goals and 18 assists. So McDavid's assist total 18 matches Matthews' points total in the head-to-head history. Let's now go to Toronto to see the latest installment.
Some of the league's best are in the building. Matthews, 3 goals from 60. McDavid on pace for 100 assists. Hyman, 2 goals from 50. The reasons to tune into this one, they are obvious.
In by Nylander. Lundgren in deep. Turns it back. Scores! Bobby McMahon has the icebreaker tonight.
Tavares gets to the puck first. McMahon puts it past his blocker. A good penalty kill creates their first power play for the Leafs.
Tripped off by Skinner in front to Matthews. Knocked off his stick. Kicked in by Lilligren. Scores! William Nylander tips it in. And he's got 39.
And what a tip this is. It did hit his skate after it hit his stick. You can see the look of Stuart Skinner. He can't believe he got it past him.
In comes Holmberg. He pulled down. Matthews from the corner. Up with an in front.
This is where those kind of emotions can get a little bit of a spark.
Now the Leafs have a 3-on-1. It's McMahon in the middle. Back to McMahon in front. Scores! Pontus Holmberg doubles down.
What a period it's been for number 29.
Tavares over the line. Nylander in flight. Breaks on.
And this is just a perfect shot.
Here's Connor McDavid once again. Looking his way in front. Hyman scores! Number 49 for Zach Hyman. And it looked like Connor McDavid was determined to get it onto the stick of 18.
Number 49 for number 18.
McDavid out of the corner. Working his way into the slot. Nice pass. Get front scores! Corey Perry. Power play goal.
Evander Kane. With just a great pass across, and Perry's not going to miss that one.
A stutter step there on Benoit, who didn't bite.
Domi Kadma.
And away we go.
I saw the sticks drop, and it looked like they collided, but they went right at each other, and both were willing combatants, I believe.
Under 4 to go. McDavid, great pass. With the tip, and it's 5-3.
I don't know if Samsonov's hurt here. He's having a hard time getting himself up. He's still flat on his chest as he slid across to make the save.
Now, Martin Jones, in relief of the injured Ilya Samsonov, Holmberg tried to tip it out, didn't get it out. Matthews, empty net, got it!
Gets one step closer to number 60 for the second time in his career.
The mistakes that we made were too costly. Just they were able to get that puck to the slot for the first goal against, where we're all in good positions, but just it's got to be harder for them to make that play. So, yeah, I think tonight we didn't make many mistakes, but when we did, there were big ones, and they capitalized on them. And you know, it was unfair for Stu. I'm not sure any of those chances he's going to have, but. Yeah, I think the chances we gave were too big.
All right, so Austin Matthews had a goal and an assist. Connor McDavid had 3 assists. But William Nylander continued his goal streak, extending it to 5 games. It's the third time this season that Nylander has a goal in at least 5 straight games, becoming just the 3rd different Leaf to do so.
Carter Verhaeghe's been a scoring drought. Snapped in and they score! Tipped out in front! And the Panthers lead 1-0.
This is Matthew Tkachuk who's going to get the deflection. There's the deflection from Tkachuk. It pops up upwards over the right shoulder of Shesterkin, who's not able to react, and the Panthers have the first goal. It's week by week, these games get more and more physical, more and more intense.
And Trocheck tripped, and a penalty here on Florida. Might have prevented Trocheck from walking right down the slot with that trip. Here's Tarasenko, and it's snatched by Shesterkin, and then some unpleasantries after the whistle. Just about everybody in the ice involved for Florida. It's Reinhart with Lundell. Centers one for Luostarinen, and he scores. Into Luostarinen off the rush. Just 21 seconds into the second period in a 2-0 Florida lead.
Fox tries to deny that pass. He can't get there, and Luostarinen chips it into the empty side.
A holding call is whistled against Paul Maurice's team.
Great opportunity here as Oposo has got Adam Fox all wrapped up for the Rangers to have this lead.
Now Fox with some room, walks down the slot and scores! Adam Fox, a power play goal!
And when that puck goes to Trocheck and back to Fox, he's got nothing but room in front of him. He can walk in, he can pick his spot, and his career high goal season continues at 14 in the Rangers power play strikes.
Pops up high for Trocheck. Off it goes, and they score! Panarin on a one-timer! Two quick goals for the Rangers, and a 2-2 tie!
Goal 42 for Panarin. Trocheck just knows where he is. He doesn't even look at him. 2 minutes and 1 second. A 2-0 Panther lead. No more.
Montour, Verhaeghe, in the circle, he scores! Carter Verhaeghe, finally, for Florida. And they take a 3-2 lead with 4:08 to go. Just the second shot on goal of the period for the Cats.
This is a bullet by Verhaeghe.
Panthers with 3.5 to go. Have the lead, not for long. Knocked in by Lafreniere as Panarin sent it to the net.
This will be the second of the night for Artemi Panarin through a mass of humanity in front of the net. 42 seconds. This game is weird in so many different ways, but the Rangers have come back to tie.
He goes 2-on-1 with Zibanejad, with Lundell back. Zibanejad out in front, and a great stop by Bobrovsky off Chris Kreider. Florida 2-1 in shootouts. New York is 1-3. Mika Zibanejad, the owner of 291 career goals. Oh, a beauty. Slipped it to the backhand and just slid it into the net. Had two goals in regulation. Wide start to the left. And he scores. Great patience by both Zibanejad and Panarin. Vladimir Tarasenko. Stopped by Shesterkin. And the Rangers win it in the shootout.
Honestly, I didn't think we played a bad period in the first. They had a one nice opportunity in front. Chuck had a good tip, and I thought for the rest of that period we played pretty well, pretty solid, played pretty well defensively. Second period, I thought we had a little bit more push offensively. We were playing a little bit harder on the forecheck. I think that ended up being the key. Third period was tight both ways, and overtime shootout. Yeah, it was a big one for us. They beat us twice already this year, so we owed them one, and two of the best teams in the East. It's going to be fun down the stretch.
So Artemi Panarin continues to climb the Ranger leaderboards. Two goals in this one, now sits at 99 points, extending his career high. With 11 games left, there's no doubt that Panarin makes his way further up the list of most points in a season in the Rangers' 97-year history. Coming up, a big fight in Nashville tonight, but it wasn't just Mo Sider and Phil Forsberg doing the do-si-do and away they go. It was also a catfish and an octopus. Find out who came out on top in both clashes next. The NHL team in Music City has been hitting all the right notes. Nashville, 14-0-2 as the Preds hosted Detroit. The 16-game point streak, a franchise record, and a tie for the longest point streak in the league this season, matching Edmonton's run earlier in the season. As for the Red Wings, only one victory in their last nine, But the win Thursday over the Isles marked the return of Dylan Larkin, who scored twice after an 8-game absence. The Red Wings began play in the second wild card spot in the East, leading the Idle Caps by 1 point.
Nashville trying to get the point streak up to 17.
Uh-oh, here we go.
The Predators didn't think that went out of play, and now we've got a scrum right off the hop.
But watch McCarron. He gets, this is after the aftermath. McCarron put that puck. He just slid it in. The whistle had went. So that's kind of a sign of disrespect, if you will, or trying to get things going.
In smash good. This one means a lot. This one loose in front. Picks up DeBrincat. Backhander sucked by Soros.
DeBrincat in all alone, and watch Soros push and just attacks that stick blade and just smothers DeBrincat. He had absolutely nowhere to go. Soros read it all alone, took away everything from Alex DeBrincat.
Battle for the puck along the board. Mata, a full swing there by Evangelista. Doesn't get out. Thrown into sticks. It's still loose. Soros has it behind him. He's facing the net. He's got to get up quickly. And a diving play. Evangelista gets it back to the neutral zone.
Watch this. Yossi comes flying across. Shen comes in there. There's Jankowski. Novak's going down, and then Evangelista finishes it off with a diving poke check away. Everybody wearing goalie. Soros is trying to battle and keep that thing covered, but look at everybody contributing on that play to get that puck the heck out of there.
Went back. Here's Larkin. Forsberg mixing it up with Sider, and they're going to go at it. They're going to dump the puck.
The mix.
Oh, my goodness. Forsberg with some right hands to the young defenseman Sider. Sider's a lot taller. Forsberg's a lot older. They're going at it. Listen to this crowd. An uppercut by Sider. You don't see Forsberg dropping very often. Oh, he comes back with a cross with the right. Sider still throwing the hard left hand.
This is what it's all about. Emotion. They're not squaring off. This is pure emotion. Two teams, two players going at it, doing whatever it takes for their team.
Box is spared back to Sissons. The shot. Beats it out.
Calm, cool, great positioning, and Sissons tries to go far side. Eyes on the puck, has Lyon. Great scoring chance, but an even better save.
Back in for Nyquist, dropped it back to O'Reilly to Forsberg.
Oh, wow.
A save by a confident Lyon.
That is a very big save by Lyon on a goal scorer. He's got 38 already this year. If somebody goes to sleep here for a split second, this game could go either way.
Oh, my, Laundry. Nashville reloads. They've got the Red Wings on the run. Yossi, fanned on the shot. Tries to follow it up. A backhander by Forsberg. His shot is good! Philip Forsberg gives the Predators the lead.
Turns around, sticks with it, gets to the forehand, under the bar. Look at the stick-to-itiveness of Philip Forsberg. Lyon gets a piece, but not enough.
Shutout for Soros. 15-0-2. The Predators keep moving forward.
Obviously, a lot of huge blocks at the end too. So yeah, we showed we were relentless again and find a way. I think we just kind of kept our focus all the way and haven't really thought too much about that this week. But yeah, we're still building. But yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Maybe not our best game, but we hung in there. Obviously, juice was great for us all night, and third period I thought was our best period, and ended up being enough. I think that's something that we've been trying to pride ourselves on our third periods, and obviously we came out, played our best period of the night in the third, and obviously we had a lot of chances that we could have scored on, and it was great to get that last one.
So the Preds keep the point streak going now at 17 games. That's the longest for any team this season. The two biggest contributors were Philip Forsberg and goalie UC Soros. Forsberg extended his goal streak to 5 games. That's the longest for a Predator since Roman Yossi 4 seasons ago. And Soros stopped all 22 shots for his 22nd career shutout.
Islanders trying to get some more offense going. They've been outscored 26-9 during this 6-game slide. They score! Clutterbuck right off the faceoff bangs it in. And the Islanders with an early 1-0 lead.
Just being faceoff ready, Domestikov. He tries to bump it back. Clutterbuck, he wants to hold up, and you see the miscommunication. What a start for the Islanders.
McLean to the net. Clutterbuck shoots, score! Clutterbuck's got 2 in the opening 9 minutes.
Romanov gets it all the way over to Matty Martin. Great shot there by Clutterbuck as he gets it up in the toy department. And what a shot that is. Oh, hat trick alert. Alert. Go out and buy your
Relay to head. Here's Vlad Domestikov in alone. Scores! Oh, they needed that one. Vlad Domestikov on a breakaway gets his 10th of the season, and it's 2-1.
How about that? In a game where the Islanders nearly perfect, very few breakdowns, if any at all, defensively, and Domestikov uses his speed to catch the Islanders off guard here. Look at the moves. 1-2-3 into the back of the net. That's the 10th goal of the season. 13 different 10-goal scores now for the Winnipeg Jets.
Here comes Horvat, leaves it for Nelson. Nelson across for Paul Mary. Scores! That was a thing of beauty. Nelson Horvat in the final touch for Kyle Paul Mary.
Just a tremendous shot. Great pass by Brock Nelson, but oh my goodness. That was, as you said, spectacular.
Islanders on their six-game winning streak outscored their opponents 11-1 in the first period. Today, the 3-1 lead after the opening 20. They switch sides and try and keep up that same momentum. Open fashion to the net. Scores! Matt Barzell found a wide-open Hudson Fashing. It's 4-1.
That thing started with a puck along the wall. Anders Lee gets it around to Matt Barzell. You pull it off, you win those battles, you get that open ice.
I would have to say the Jets have been grounded.
Barzell for Dobson downhill with a shot. Lee tipped it just wide.
Oh, what a play that was. Good read by Dobson.
Barzell to the front, Fashing a chance. Pulled it free. Can't get it through Hellebuck. They score! Barzell pushed it the final inch. 5-1 New York.
They kept pulling it back and go to the net. Matt Barzell, the shots 25-4 for the New York Islanders. Who would have guessed this against one of the best defensive teams in hockey?
So for the first time this season, the Jets make a goaltending change mid-game.
This is the first time all season they've given up 5 goals in 5-on-5. Fashing, Lee scores! It's a 6-1 Islanders lead as Anders Lee scores his 18th. Fashing, first career three-point game for Hudson Fashing, and all 3 points have been here in the second period.
This is turning into a rout.
Curling into it, Ehlers dashing up the wing. Nikolai Ehlers with a shot. Big rebound, and Appleton scores. What a reaction from Mason Appleton, a career-high 13, and it's 6-2. Stolen away by Cole Perfetti. Tried to tee it up. It was knocked away, but he got it back. Perfetti wrists it. Scores! A seeing eye shot from Cole Perfetti. Gets his first in 24 games. His 15th makes it 6-3.
Out of the first period, the Islanders led 3-1 after one, 6-1 after two, and they end their six-game losing streak with a 6-3 win on home ice.
So the Islanders snapped their six-game losing streak thanks in part to Matthew Barzell, who matches his career-high in goals in a season with 22. You have to go back 6 seasons to find the last time he scored that many, his rookie campaign in which he brought home the Calder Trophy. You could say that Matthew is raising the bar as his team fights for a playoff spot. And speaking of the playoffs, this is the race for the second wild-card spot in the Eastern Conference. Detroit lost. Caps idle. Islanders get 2 points. So you have the Wings in the second wild card position. Caps 1 point back, and the Islanders 3 points out of the mix. Coming up, Jordan Kyrou had a hat trick, but that wasn't the reason why Minnesota was wild with frustration. Stick around to see what got Marc-Andre Fleury and Matt Boldy so heated in a must-win situation on the Fly. Nick. Welcome back, everyone, to On the Fly. Time now to check out the highlights from the Blues against the Wild.
The Wild and the Blues neck and neck in the standings. A win for Minnesota would leap them ahead of the Blues and put them 3 points out of the final spot in the Western Conference.
Nick Leddy, a former first-round draft choice of the Wild, never played here in Minnesota, but he comes home to play in game number 1,000.
Now Neighbors and Thomas, they come in. Pass in front, backhander by Shen. They score! Neighbors, I think, gets the rebound on an odd man break, and the Blues have taken a 1-0 lead.
Well, stop me if you've heard this before. Jake Neighbors with a goal in the blue paint.
Faber jumps up in the rush, has Boldy with him at the Blues line. Boldy to Johansson. Down low, Faber centers. Johansson scores!
This is the play right here. Brock just pitches it to the outside, goes to the net. Matt Boldy doing a great job of using his body, and what an unbelievable give and go there by Marcus Johansson, moving to open ice, and that's a tap in.
Thomas able to hold his own. Neighbors down the slot, centers, and Fleury sprawls across to get a piece of it. He's lost his glove and his stick on the play. As the Wild start back, Rossi in alone. Rossi scores!
200-foot game. Watch this defensive play. In the defensive zone, saves a goal right there. And then on the offensive side, Kirill Kaprizov finds the young Phenom right through the middle, and he's able to squeeze that one right through the wickets. All kinds of time there. Kind of falls and trips on himself. Takes the goaltender out. Puck crosses the goal line.
And was checked on the back check by Hustadinov. Kyrou stays with it. Flies it free to Buchnevich. In front. Another shot. They score! Tipped in! And the Blues have tied it on a goal by Jordan Kyrou.
Well, persistence paid off that shift for sure, as Jordan Kyrou started everything, lost the puck, then regained the puck, and then the Blues stayed hungry on the loose pucks. This is why they were rewarded.
Rossi comes to center, leaves it for Kaprizov. Kaprizov across, Zuccarello to Rossi, he scores!
Kirill Kaprizov through the neutral zone, finding Zuccarello on the far side, looking to pass. 20th goal for Marco Rossi.
Nice pass for Buchnevich. He'll charge in. The Kyrou shoots, and he scores! Kyrou, from distance, has tied the game at three. What a shot!
Jordan Kyrou just flat-out beats Marc-Andre Fleury.
With 10 to go. And the Blues to center. Kyrou gets by a man. He's got a break for the hat trick. Shoots, he scores! Kyrou gets the hat trick! And the Blues have a 4-3 lead. His fourth career hat trick.
This is exactly what Jordan Kyrou can bring to the table. And boy, has he brought it the last couple of games. This one here buries his hat trick goal. We got a couple of hats on the ice here.
Middleton shot deflected, and they score!
In full desperation mode, getting the defenseman involved, beats his check to the front of the net.
And we're underway, 3-on-3.
Here comes Saad, gets it back to the net. Saad shoots, he scores! Saad, goodbye! Blues have won at 5-4 in overtime, a huge win as Saad buries it.
Saad protects the puck and then zips that home, and boys are celebrating after that. They know just how big that extra point was.
Anthony Mantha trying to bank that in on Tarasov. He's going to hold tight. That was an alert play by Mantha. Tried to throw that in from below the goal line.
Good instincts on this play. Recognize Tarasov a little out of position as Mantha takes us behind the goal line. You can see that skate just got it. Tarasov was about to pull it away from the net and was enough to hang on.
Now it's sent to the point. Gudbranson with a shot and score! Gudbranson floats one through, it goes uphill, and it's 1-0 Columbus on their first shot on goal.
Well, nice play here, simple hockey for the Blue Jackets, and Hill does not look comfortable. Keep an eye on 42, see Gudbranson, he sees that net front presence, and it's Gudbranson's goal here, and the guys are excited. Good job by the veteran.
Fifth goal of the season.
Great shot from Barbashev, denied by Tarasov, rebound score!
The face-off, the rebound comes right out high. Good save initially, and a great follow-up by Ivan Barbashev. His first and 11 in the Golden Ice tie this game at one.
Out high, Whitecloud with a drive, side rebound, score! Jack Eichel puts it home on the rebound, and the Golden Knights with two quick ones. Career point number 500 for Eichel.
He talks about smart plays. Eichel just a little dump as Stevenson comes in, stops up, low to high. To the net, and Eichel goes around, comes out from behind the goal line, and is wide open. The rebound comes right to him as he puts it past Tarasov.
Theodore back to Mantha. Now Theodore looking, feeds it across, back to Dorfiev, stick cannon, trying to tuck it in, and he scores! What a finish by Pavel Dorfiev!
Mantha, Theodore, and then the cross-ice pass, Shane Theodore, there's the move in, out! And still able to get enough of that to push it across the line. Double digits for Dorfiev, his 10th, as the Golden Knights have the 3-1 lead. Aiden Hill coming out of the game. This is the last save as Sillinger lets it go. It's a left pad save.
Eichel walks in, scores!
Jets. Jack Eichel picks the corner on the power play. His second of the night to make it 4-1. And it's 5 wins in their last 7 overall. The 4-2 victory over the Blue Jackets.
All right, so with that win over Columbus, the Golden Knights maintain their 4-point lead over the Blues in the West wild card. We're talking about the race for the second wild card spot in the conference. Monday, critical, as these two, the Golden Knights and the Blues, will square off head-to-head in St. Louis.
And Byfield's up the ice with room. He's in. Saved by Vasilevsky. Byfield, who's sitting on 19 goals. He's having a very strong season.
Give Byfield credit there with getting to the inside, taking the ice available.
Lost an edge. And the Lightning away with it. Kings have numbers coming back. A pass in front. Shot. Save is made in tight. Oh, a great look there for Mitchell Chafee.
There's some intensity in this game for sure. This is East versus West. They only see each other twice a year.
Here's Kopitar off the wall. They
score. Kopitar to Kempe. 1-0 LA.
Look at that pass. That is just perfectly placed on the stick.
Got to give it to Kempe. Boy, that bottom hand had some weight to it.
This is the huge key for tonight. Number one versus number one.
Dying seconds of this first period. Hangs on. Fans on the shot. Puck is loose. They score! He fanned on the initial shot, but they found the rebound. It's a power play goal for Braden Point. And it's 1-1.
The Los Angeles Kings will give you the low play around the net.
We expected a good game, and so far that's exactly what we have.
And a shot from the blue line. Tip score! Trevor Moore had the loose puck fall right at his feet. No chance for Vasilevsky.
Kings get a bounce, and Moore gets an easy one, and it's 2-1. Los Angeles.
So it's good to see the Kings with traffic around the net.
You're up one, third period. You gotta get two out of this.
Sends it out to the blue line. Nobody there. Chased down Anderson. 2-on-1. Anderson in. Shoots. Scores! Mikey Anderson with a laser. And the Kings get a huge insurance goal early in the third. They're up 3-1.
Kings score early in the second. They score earlier here in the third.
Critical power play here. Lightning definitely need one.
Here's Point down. Out of the corner, back to Stamkos. Scores! Steven Stamkos with a one-timer to the top corner.
This is unstoppable.
Now it's nervous time.
Looks back to Victor Hedman again. Final minute of regulation. Kucherov across Stamkos. And it's 3-3 in the final minute.
And here is Kempe to center ice. Plays it across. Speeding in. A break to win it. Gavrikov scores! Vladdy Gavrikov in overtime. 25 seconds in. The Kings win it. 4-3.
The Kings get two goals from defensemen.
For Gavrikov, his third career overtime goal. His first as a King.
It's an overtime game winner powered by Energizer. Vladislav Gavrikov with the winner, but Adrian Kempe set him up to send everyone home. Kempe has been stellar in his last 7 games with 3 goals and 8 assists in that span.
27 times they've scored the first goal of a hockey game. These Vancouver Canucks, they come out of the gate in a hurry.
Here's Connor Garland cutting to the middle, a pass in front. His 21st of the season, right on cue for you, Greg Millen. Another opening goal. Now the 48th time the Canucks have done that this season. So able to keep that out and get back into his crease. Here's a chance for Condon. Hospital racing up front. And a diving play by Teddy Bluger to save the day. And a defensive effort on the back check from the speedy forward. Heinz Gottlieb. He's navigating through, handing it off to Hospital, delivering to and he's off the iron. So the Flames coming real close. Crossing the blue line. Connor's there. Trying to hand it off to Godley, but Garland was there to take that puck away. A chance. A 2-on-0. Hoglander prepares it. Hoglander scores a beauty! Second of the night. 26 second of the season, and it's 2-0 for Vancouver.
Well, Zeri with a young mistake on the boards. It's a 2-on-0, and Hoglander with a beautiful play. Now he's down and out, and then he just comes around him and chips it over Markstrom for a beautiful goal.
Time winding down here in the second period. Rasmus Anderson looks for A.J. Greer. He finds Kevin Rooney, who dishes. Greer takes it. Rasmus Anderson shoots and scores! The Flames cut the deficit in half in the late stages of the second period. And Rasmus Anderson's eighth of the season has the Flames on the board.
And just rifles one right past the Smith.
I think the Canucks are okay with it, given that this power play. And a goal for Miller, the insurance marker. Point number 90 on the season for JT Miller, his 34th of the season, and the Canucks are up by two.
Well, you give him a couple looks on the power play. This is a very good power play for Vancouver. A little give and go with Besser back to Miller. And through traffic here this time, that should seal the deal for the Vancouver Canucks with 3:18 to go.
Here's Markstrom now making his way to the bench. Extra attacker coming on there. And this puck is sent into the gaping open net. 4-1. And it's Elias Lindholm scoring against his former team.
It's been over a month since he has scored a goal, the last time against the Detroit Red Wings.
To Smith again on cue. Blocker in that away. The Flames do score here with 17.7 left on the clock. And that is Joel Hanley's goal, his first in a Calgary Flames uniform. Evan Rooney has it, and that's going to do it. Win number 45 on the season for the Vancouver Canucks. A 4-2 victory against the Calgary Flames.
A nice feed for Zetterlund, and they score! Thomas Bortolo on the redirect.
Beautifully located by Bortolo, up and over Mrazek's shoulder, top corner for the goal.
On for the Blackhawks, and it could have easily be 3-0 here. Here's Bortolo again, and he scores again! Thomas Bortolo, 2 in the first period. We shall see. A good start. The year, the Sharks can make Chicago pay for that hit right here, and they do, and it's Sutherland, and it's 4-0. The Sharks scored twice in the first 84 seconds. Radish, a drive, a save by Cooley, rebound, score. Ryan Donato gets the Hawks on the board.
There we go, snap that shutout skid right there, and it's a start.
In front, Johnson scores, and the Hawks have scored back. Back goals, and it's 4-2. Flipped for Jones in the circle. He flicks the wrist and scores! It's a one-goal game. The Chicago net is empty. Athanasiu in the paint. Barishev alongside. They score! And tie the game in the final minute. Overtime in the Shark Tank. He finds Seth Jones. Jones shoots! He scores! The Hawks win it! And come all the way back.
You believe that? And what a shot by Jones. That wrister, lethal. They hum back from a 4-0 deficit.
It's another overtime game winner powered by Energizer as Seth Jones completes a comeback. The Blackhawks trailed 4-0 in the second period, but clawed their way back and tied their second largest comeback win in franchise history. Coming up, Sean Couturier finally back in the mix for the Flyers. How would that impact Philly's afternoon tilt against the Bruins? Important game coming up next on the Fly.
Supposed to be hard, man. These trophies is our scars. Ain't nobody gonna give me something.
It's this drama, the horse race down the very end of the regular season, that captivates us. And for these Philadelphia Flyers to take on the Bruins, this is a huge game, we all know.
Now lost in the neutral zone. Bodies fly. The Bruins end up with the puck. And now we get a whistle.
Pucks up in the air, and that's definitely knee on knee. Should have been called. Now they got Marchand for unsportsmanlike conduct. He snaps on the bench, bangs his stick a couple of times, does not get the original call, and on all this mess, Philadelphia is going to end up with a power play.
Brazo gets it up high, shot knocked out in front, good chance there for the Bruins, second opportunity, and Van Riemsdyk is shut down in front by Ersson.
It goes off Jack, Eric Johnson in front, Ersson tested big time, and able to reach out with that toenail and get it with an escape lane.
Here comes Tippett to the net, drive! Just fly it down that right side.
Both these goaltenders now coming up with some key saves for their team.
So third power play opportunity for the Flyers. Here's Konechny now. Gets it over to Palin. Throws in the slot. There, great chance and a goal! So they do score on the power play. It's Travis Konechny. Hanging around in front. And he beats Omar and the Flyers. Around the board, and here come the Flyers the other way. It's got Lawton on the breakaway. Lawton moves in, back in. Oh, what a stop by Omar! He stays with it and flashes the glove.
And a diabolical save by Omar to keep this a one-goal deficit for Boston. Could have been two.
Coyle for the Bruins. Gets it to Brasso. For Konechny, hit shot, and he scores! Travis Konechny throws it at the net. The Flyers strike with 4:44 left in regulation and regain the lead. It's 2-1. There's Geeky now, 1-on-5, throws it through.
Response by Boston.
There's Palin, backhand pass, a shot there off the pipe and in! It looked like it deflected off the Bruins stick just as Konechny's shot deflected off McAvoy's stick on goal two. And this one could be the difference. Flyers get it, they flip it up, out, and that is going to do it as the Boston Bruins are going to run out of time. The Flyers on home ice get it done.
Big win this afternoon for Philadelphia and the Flyers.
Well, Bill, it was a tight game for most of the afternoon between the Bruins and the Flyers. Scoreless until late in the second, and then Travis Konechny on the Power's struggling, to say the least, power play, gets one. It went back and forth from there. In the end, the Flyers win. But once again, Travis Konechny, he had two in this game, 30 on the season. Second straight year with 30 goals. He's the heartbeat of the Flyers.
What a year. As he goes, the Flyers go. If they're looking for someone to change the tempo, score a big goal, all year it has been Konechny. No different than tonight. Struggling on the power play, gets out there late in the second period. Not much happening through the first, second. Looking for maybe something to do it, maybe a power play. They get that chance, a little breakdown, him in front, 1-0. And then the wild shootout in the third period. We started to see it open up a little bit, back and forth, but some mental fortitude by the Flyers, and they hang on late by a game-winning goal by Tyson Forster.
Yeah, Forster gets it done late, and the Philadelphia Flyers find a way to win. And another thing you pointed out, Billy, is they just continue to block shots. They had 18 more block shots in the game today. I think they frustrated some of the Bruins shooters.
They eat pucks like nobody's business. They don't have to play man-on-man in their own end. It can be a zone defense, keep everything to the outside. And lay-in. We saw it late. Pasternak had a one-timer. They sacrificed the body. And that goes to John Tortorella and their DNA and what they want to be. Block shots, commitment, back check, strong through the neutral zone, better defensively. Pretty complete all-around game from Philadelphia this afternoon.
And another 2 points for the Flyers. It's been a good week. They had three tough games against Toronto, Carolina, and now the Boston Bruins. They end up with 5 of those 6 points, 81 points on the season. They hold on to that third spot in the Metro Division. So things are looking good as the Flyers inch towards the finish line. We'll see if they can keep it going. They're right back in action, Billy, against the Florida Panthers at home tomorrow on Sunday. And then for the Boston Bruins, they're just starting a 6-game road trip. This was game number one. They get a couple of days off, and then they got a tough assignment in Florida on Tuesday, in Tampa on Wednesday. The Bruins will be looking
no easy
back
games
on track. No, there isn't.
And this time of year.
Yeah, the Devils 5 for their last 7 on the power play. Ottawa 31st out of 32 on the penalty kill.
Holla has to reach back for it. He turned it over. Joseph's got it. Short-handed. Joseph's scores. Allen thought he had it, but he didn't have all of it. And Matthew Joseph snaps it home for his first goal since February 19th, and Ottawa is on the board first.
John Marino's about to come out of the penalty box, but first a hard drive from Shane Pinto. He turned it over. Jesper Bratt's coming in on a breakaway. Marino's out of the box. Bratt to the front. He scores! Jesper Bratt's first goal in 12 games ties it.
Well, that's exactly what the Devils needed to get going. First shift of the second period.
Dawson Mercer attacks forward. Tkachuk spilled it, and Nosek scores! Tomas Nosek puts the Devils ahead with 2 goals in the opening minute of period two.
And Tkachuk and Ball extend their conversation. Now it's Joseph in tight. Ridley Gregg with a chance. He scores! What a play by Ridley Gregg to get it around Jake Allen. At center, got it ahead. Claude Giroux hands it off. Dropped it back for Chabot. Played across, scores! Angus Cruikshank wires it under the bar and in. What a shot and a big goal for Ottawa. Ottawa with a break. 3-on-1. Tkachuk loads it up. Got it across, scores! Thomas Chabot will bury it. Played it up through center. That was blocked. Batherson brings it in. He'll go to the net. Scores! Drake Batherson with a great backhand shot into the top corner. And they'll go home with 2 points and a win as the Senators escape the Rock with a 5-2 victory.
Time now for your Top Shelf plays of the night.
Parayko moving in, and a long save by Fleury.
Unbelievable save by Marc-Andre Fleury.
With Lundell back, Zibanejad out in front, of a great stop by Bobrovsky off Chris Kreider. Game-saving stop by the great Russian goaltender Sergei Bobrovsky. Mika Zibanejad, the owner of 291 career goals. Oh, a beauty. Slipped it to the backhand and just slid it into the net.
Just comes around him and chips it over Markstrom for a beautiful goal. The Canucks, a 2-0 lead and a timely goal for them.
He's got a break for the hat trick. Shoots, he scores! Cairo gets the hat trick, and the Blues have a 4-3 lead. His fourth career hat trick.
Welcome back, everyone. Sunday showcase game pits Winnipeg against Washington. The Caps trail Detroit by 1 point for the second wildcard spot in the East. Sunday's coverage begins at noon Eastern with NHL Tonight. Then it's E.J. Raddick and Billy Lindsay. They have a game call at 12:30 p.m. Eastern time. Elsewhere here on NHL Network on Monday at 6 p.m. Eastern, NHL Tonight's women's show will be live at UBS Arena, where PWHL New York hosts PWHL Boston. Catherine Tappan and Lauren Gardner will be joined by players and special guests, including our own Jamie Hirsch, who has been doing play-by-play for New York's games all season. Speaking of Jamie Hirsch, she was on hand for the Patty Kazmaier Award announcement earlier on Saturday. Take a look.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this year's Patty Kazmaier Memorial Award from Cornell University is Izzy Daniel. Izzy, congratulations. You are a Patty Kazmaier Award winner. You were pretty surprised when I called your name. What was that like?
I mean, it was surreal. Like you said, I was so surprised. There's so many great players who are worthy of this honor, and I'm really humbled and honored that to receive this award. I still can't believe it, and just thanks to everyone who supported me and helped me get here.
Who was just the most instrumental in your path to this point?
There's so many people, but obviously my parents. Everything they sacrificed for me in my hockey career has been tremendous, whether it's waking up and dragging me out of bed at 6 a.m. when I didn't want to go, or driving me to Canada or whatever it is, and always being there for me after a big win or a tough loss. It didn't matter. They were always so supportive and happy for me, and also all my coaches, especially Scott Bowlby. He really was the one who took a chance on me and got me to where I am today as a hockey player. I was kind of just a Bambi on ice, and he kind of turned me into a hockey player. So I owe a lot of my career to him. And then obviously Coach Reed at Blake, want to thank him for all he's done. And then all my coaches at Cornell, especially Coach, he's so dedicated and passionate about his players and our program. And he's done so much for me both on and off the ice. So just thank you.
So congrats to Izzy Daniel on becoming this season's Patty Kazmaier Award winner. She tallied 59 points with 21 goals and 38 assists in 34 games. She becomes the first player to win the award from Cornell University. From Cornell, critical information. Time now for your three stars of the night. The third star is Bobby McMahon, who helped the Maple Leafs to a 6-3 win over the Oilers. He had two goals and an assist in Toronto's win. Number two star, UC Saros, who stopped all 22 shots he faced against the Red Wings in a 1-0 shutout, extending Nashville's point streak to 17 games. And the number one star of the night, Jordan Kyrou, the Blues, collected his fourth career hat trick in a huge win for St. Louis, 5-4 over the Minnesota Wild. Before we go, we wanted to show you this incredible assist from Ryan Leonard in BC's 6-2 win over BU in the Hockey East title game. BU number one in the country, BU number two in the country. What a pass there to Will Smith, who scored four goals. Macklin Celebrini scored a goal in the loss. He's expected to be the number one overall pick, but it's BC that wins the Hockey East championship by the count of 6-2. So that'll do it for On the Fly. I'm Bill Pito. Thanks so much for watching as we leave you now with the best from Saturday.
Getting you set for puck drop on a Saturday afternoon.
He scores! Kyrou gets the hat trick! His fourth career hat trick!
Back-to-back number one picks head-to-head tonight on a Spotlight Saturday.
Stanley Cup, 15-0-2. The Predators keep moving forward, and the record is still intact.